organizing, and processing data. Question: as you think about exploring the data that you have collected, what are the approaches that you use to organize your data and or process your data before you make meaning from the data?
My name is Ali Omar. I'm the Acting Deputy Director of Science at NASA Langley Research Center. In this recording, I'm going to discuss what you need to consider as you explore NASA's data from the Earth observing satellites. In the first place, you need to identify exactly what data you need and what phenomenon you're trying to study. For example, if you need to look at droughts, maybe you want to look at rainfall data from one of the rainfall observing satellites. And so you determine what information you expect to get from it, and also what region and what time are you looking at. Because NASA's data is vast, the volumes can be very large, and you want to order or download only the data for your region or for your time to make it easily accessible. Otherwise, the data volume is too large. You want to read very carefully the instructions that come with the data. Data is distributed by the Distributed Active Archive Centers, so-called the DACs, and they also provide instructions on how to use the data and a description of some of the limitations of the data. And usually these are in the form of a user manual that will identify missing data, gaps, data with very large uncertainties, or data that's not available for certain periods of time that you want to study. You also want to know what the resolution of the data is, and this comes with the data also. Is this data 1 kilometer by 1 kilometer or 5 kilometers by 5 kilometers? So if you're studying a phenomenon that's very that happens on a very small scale at a very within a very small region or even at a neighborhood level, you need data that's high resolution, like 1 kilometer by 1 kilometer. If you're studying rainfall, 10 kilometers by 10 kilometers is fine. So you want to see what's the best resolution you can get the data at. The third thing you want to pay attention to is what format does the data come in. So because of the large volume of data, NASA uses different formats to make sure that the data is compressed and they can transfer a large amount of data. And so depending on the format of the data, you may need special tools. These tools are usually available from the data centers. Every data center has a call center or a help desk. If you call that help desk, they will let you know exactly where the tools can be found on their websites, and you can download these tools. You can use these tools to manipulate the data. In a lot of cases, to put the data in spreadsheets where you can plot them by yourself, or even to use tools that they have that you can use to plot maps of the data and look at trends on how the data is changing from time to time, if you're looking at a time series, or if you just want to look at the daily average, maybe aerosol optical depth, the amount of particles in the air, for determining how maybe clean the air is in your region. Or you want to look at what the effects of maybe wildfire event is, and how that is going to be transported to your region. I hope this has been helpful. Again, if you have any questions, always the NASA data center's help desk is available to answer questions. Thank you.